Don't say Blue Note. Okay, I've said it. Yeah, I'm not going to say it.
Hey, y'all. Welcome back to Texas Physical Truth. I'm Dave.
I'm Steve.
I'm Nick.
And
what are we talking about?
We've been out for a minute. We're talking about Blue Run.
But before we talk about Blue Run.
Oh, don't forget to hit the like, subscribe, bell notification. You know where they're at. I'm not going to point to them anymore.
I think it's down, not up, right?
Yeah, I think it's down. Yeah. Nobody puts a bell up down. Yeah.
I don't know. Subscribes up here.
I don't think so.
Notifications down there, or vice versa.
On the bottom.
All right, well, whatever. Do what you're supposed to do.
At least we know who doesn't watch our videos.
That's follow right. The channel.
You should probably support us, Dave.
You definitely should support us.
Maybe hit subscribe.
Hit subscribe.
I'm talking to you.
I did.
Okay.
Right now. Right. Just did it.
Okay. Well, hey, beyond all that, Dave's right. It's been
a minute.
It's been a minute, for sure. I think kind of all of us were all over the place and couldn't get ourselves together to do a video. So we're back at it, and we figured we might as well jump straight into this with a hitter. And
but the podcast is running
strong. The podcast is still running strong. We did find
the podcast
time to talk. Yeah. So, Nick, you want to open us up a little bit on what we're looking at here, and I'll talk a little bit about the history and kind of what they're about.
This is Blue Run, not to get confused with Blue Note.
My bad.
This is Blue Run. It's awesome. I don't know how to explain it. It's just great. Everything about him is great.
You know, I agree with that. this is a fairly new experience, I think, here for Dave. Have you had a lot of Blue Run?
No, I haven't had a lot of Blue Run. Okay. So
we'll get his insight here in just a second, from, a newer taster per se. But let's talk a little bit about this company. So this is essentially a COVID born company. I mean, they were founded and did their first release in October of 2020. I did see these guys online, and I'm like, what the heck is that? You know, why are, you know, bourbon ads popping up my Facebook feed? And I mean, what is this all about? I don't see this on the shelves. I don't see anything about it. So I was inclined to do a little more research on it way back then. Well, these guys, and I speak of these guys, I believe there's five of them. There's five. And I'll start with their CEO. His name is Mike Montgomery. Michael Montgomery, I apologize. Longtime political strategist. So, obviously, has a brain for marketing strategy, stuff like that, and kind of how people work and how to gain momentum on something. And I think that was hugely beneficial for these guys.
I'm guessing if you're in politics, you probably need to drink a little bit every once in a while. So
I agree with that. That's probably why he's pretty good at this. So these guys all put their heads together and started out with a vision to target a different demographic of whiskey and bourbon drinkers out there. They wanted to focus on the younger crowd. You know, they said it's not your mom and dad's or not your grandma and grandpa's bourbon market anymore. That's not who we're going to cater to. We want to cater this product to the younger generation. You know, there's going to be the 20-somethings, the 30-somethings out there that are heavily involved in social media. And we're gonna target our branding, our product right at them. And they started this as an online endeavor. And holy smokes, man, did it kill it. Mm-hmm. So the first release, 2,600 bottles, sold out in 2 weeks. Do you know how much a bottle that was?
I do. It was $170 a bottle.
$170 a bottle and sold out in two weeks. A startup.
Brand new, yeah.
That's badass.
Yeah. I remember seeing them the first time they came out. I mean, it's totally different, the logo on it. And as you can tell, they change it constantly, which is, there's a whole point behind that. The thing is about the founders and the co-founders is they're so widely different, and they're not what you would expect. Like Steve had said, one was a political strategist for somewhere, company, something. Another one was a Nike designer. There was a very first entry or director level employee for Facebook. Another was a hospitality exec, and then one was a philanthropist. So just five guys from like all different walks of life. Getting together and starting this.
And talking about the Nike guy, this is the same guy that was responsible for designing Air Force Ones. Now, if you're as old as Dave and I, you realize, man, they keep you stomping in your Air Force Ones,
right? That's right. That's absolutely it, man.
So, shout out to Nelly back in the day for that song. But Air Force Ones for Nike were huge. They were well designed, and they just became an instant hit. And I think that's very close to what this bottle's doing. So we've got the gentleman that's responsible for designing that, put together a bottle that's, you know, it's very appealing to the eye. And Nick made a good reference earlier. It's like collecting, like cards.
Yep.
you want to get one of each. They've got these great butterflies on the front. Some are different materials. They're different looks. Mm-hmm. But they're overall, they've got a really elegant feel to them. And you're not, honestly, you're not embarrassed to display them anywhere. They're, yeah, they're very
so
pretty.
So what's
model.
The significance of the butterfly?
So going off before we get to that, each one is obviously different here in front of us.
Okay.
These four are pretty much their basic. There's five total, just their normal iterations that come out all the time.
Okay.
There's a Castank, High Rye, Emerald, which is the newest release. That's not considered like an allocated release.
Okay.
So they all have their own things. Now, this one on the end was from last year's special release that they had. They did 12 bottles, different bottles, 12 different barrels, excuse me, one each day, and they released it to Sealbox and to Blue Run's website. And, I mean, it sold out within seconds or minutes, you know what I mean?
Oh, sure.
That one's money,
so
too.
I was lucky enough to be able to grab one, thanks to a mistake on their part. They put it up a little early, and I happened to be on the website and found it.
And I think that one's the notes on there is banana peanut butter on the on
that
the
is what it's actually yep. called, so it's and that the is the okay. notes you taste.
Oh, yeah. It is, man. It's pretty killer when you take a sip of that. You do hit those notes right away.
There's another one called blueberry pie. I'm sad I missed because I love blueberries.
Oh, I thought that'd be good.
Yeah, so these guys, they're really doing a good job. Now, Dave asked about the significance of the butterfly on the front of that. Well, that kind of goes down to the heart of what these guys are doing from a marketing strategy standpoint. The butterfly signifies the evolution in the bourbon industry. So, meaning that, hey, we're targeting a younger audience, we're targeting a younger market, and, you know, obviously butterflies come from caterpillars, so it's an evolution process from one thing to another, and I think they're genius for what they're doing. I mean, sure. They're hitters.
Well, and it's definitely, I mean, in a you take something that's kind of a good old boy club. I mean, if you want to think about the bourbon industry in general, I mean, there's a lot of really well-known and established players, and some of the new companies make it, some of them don't, and I really love the idea of kind of evolving that market and going after, you know, a different crowd but still staying true to, you know, a really solid bourbon product, not something that's, you know, designed to be in a craft cocktail or something like that. I mean, it's every one of these, I think I've tried all five of them tonight. So
he even mixed them in the same glass. It was kind of different.
Yeah, you know, hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. But no, they're all phenomenal quality. They all have a little subtle difference to them, but you know, I like the motif behind the butterfly and the idea behind it.
Yeah, really nice job. So we're going to jump a little deeper into this on the podcast, and we'll be doing that here shortly. Obviously, these things will release about the same time. We have a special guest with us here, giving us the evil eye here, and I'd like y'all to listen to the podcast, and we'll make an introduction there, and we'll dive a little deeper into
I think we'll hit some tasting notes and get into some of the different expressions and go from there.
For sure.
So tune into the podcast.
Yeah. But hey, until then, you know, we appreciate y'all out there, and until we get back at this again, which we'll try to be weekly again.